Hi guys, my name is Ferdy, and in this video I will show you how you can make your website more advanced using custom post types, advanced custom fields, and dynamic content within Elementor Pro. Let me show you what I mean. I show you how to create custom post types that enable you to create a new kind of page to your website, like a portfolio or real estate, movies, people, etc. For instance, you can create a custom post type called penthouses. But within those penthouse pages, I can only add a title, I can add some content and a featured image. But I want to add extra information, like the amount of space of the penthouse, storage, bathrooms, etc. That is where advanced custom fields come in. It allows me to create custom fields that enable me to fill in details about penthouses really easily. When we have done that, we can use dynamic content within Elementor Pro to gather the information about the custom fields and display them beautifully within our website. So, one more time, we can create a new post type, penthouses. Then we can create custom fields so we can fill in a lot of extra information about our penthouses and use Elementor Pro to display the information beautifully on our penthouse page. This is commonly used on real estate websites, but also on websites like IMDb and Booking.com. So for my web design agency, I added a new custom post type called case studies, and I have 6 case studies. If I click on one, you see the title, the information, and the featured image, and then below you see the advanced custom fields over here, images, titles, text, whatever. You can add a lot of things. Then with Elementor Pro, I created a template for all case studies that will display all the information from the advanced custom fields in this way. And I have this extra thing, which I'm really proud of. I'll show you how you can create something like that. Here's an overview of my case studies. You can show it like this or a little bit different or with a slider. And then if you go to 3 case studies, you see different information, but displayed the same way. And that's what you can do with custom post types, advanced custom fields, and dynamic content in Elementor Pro. If you like what you're seeing so far, please consider to like this video and feel free to subscribe for more upcoming WordPress related tutorials. Now I would like to say, let's get started. So I have my website over here made with Elementor Pro. And now I want to make use of custom post types. I assume you already have Elementor Pro. If you don't have it, you can go to ferdycorp.com/Elementor, hit enter. This is an affiliate link. If you get this through my link, you don't pay more, but I get a commission and it helps me to create those tutorials. There are free plans. If you go to pricing for 1 website, 3 websites, and 1,000 websites, and the prices are per year. So do you want to create 1 website, 3, or 1,000? It's up to you. I have a lot of tutorials about Elementor Pro 30. 3 hours, 2.5 hours, 1.5 hours. So you can learn everything about Elementor Pro. So choose your package. You can buy it over here and then you can follow along in this tutorial. So let me show you again in the background or in the back end. I showed you already. You have posts, you have pages, and they both look the same and have little different functionalities. So now we can create a custom post type. So something like players or teachers or houses or listings. So in order to do that, we go to plugins, add new, and I search for UI. And there I see it already, custom post type UI. Almost 1 million installations. I click on install now, and then we can create our own custom post type. I activate it. Then I go over here, add edit post types, and I can add one. So this is a slug. That means you don't need to use capitals, uppercase, letters. Just say what you want to say. So I want to have case studies. So I say case studies, and automatically it creates this beautiful area over here. And then plural for the label, case studies. And over here you can say houses or penthouses or listings. And then singular, so case study. Well, that's it. You can have a description if you want to. I edit. Awesome. And now I go over here to taxonomies. So what you see over here, I have case studies and I can see all case studies and add new ones, just as you see over here. And at post, you see also categories and tags. So we can add a taxonomy over here below. Add taxonomies, and I can say categories. Maybe I want to have categories in my case studies. Plural, categories, singular, category. And where should it be applied? To the case studies. Really important to check that one. Edit. And now when I hover over here, I can see them all. I can add a new one and I can add to the categories. A really important thing, if I click on add new, and I want to create one with Elementor, I cannot do that. So I need to go back to Elementor settings. And over here at post types in general, select case studies. So now if I would add a new case study, add new, I can edit it with Elementor. So let me go back again. Right now I see this icon. If I want to have a certain icon, I can go to plugins, add new, and I can search for dash icon. It is from Hal Gatewood. Thank you, Hal. You're helping us. That was a bad joke. Okay, over here. No, not over here. Let me see. I think at settings, I don't know. I'm just doing something. I have no idea what I'm doing. Dash icons. And now for my templates, we can choose something or for case studies. So what fits with case studies? This one maybe. And if I click on it over here, you see this icon. I like it. Actually, I think this one is better. And then I need to save it. No, I don't need to save it. I go to the dashboard. And here we have our case studies. So what I want to do now, I want to add a new plugin. I go to plugins, add new. We need to search for custom post, or better, ACF. Advanced custom fields. And the weird thing is that it's not on number one. Advanced custom fields. We need to search for it. Here it is, advanced. Maybe if I search for advanced custom fields. Okay, here the second one. Okay, more than 1 million installations. I click on install now. And what we can do with this, here we can add extra information fields to our case studies. Activate. So right now, if I go to case studies and I click on add new, for the third time, I can add a title, I can have a text. And then here at document, I can have a featured image. I can have a category. And that's about it. But I want to have more information. Like if you're selling houses, how many bathrooms, the amount of square feet. Maybe you want to add an image over here that can be put anywhere in the website using Elementor Pro. So we're going to add that. So we go to the custom fields. I add a field group, or I go to field groups, and then I add a new one. And here I can have a title. I call this one case studies. Now we can add extra fields to our case studies. So the first one, it can be called a company, for instance, company. And then when you enter a new case study, you need to fill in the name of the company. And over here, you can decide if it needs to be required. And if you're happy, you can say add the fields, and you can add a second one. So what's the second one? An excerpt. What do I mean with that? A small text about the company. And then you can change the field type. Right now it's a text. I can say text area, but you can have a number, range, email, URL, password, image, a lot of things over here. I choose the text area. Then I make it mandatory or required. And I can add a third field. Website URL. So I need to search for URL. It is all required. So all this information, we can fill it in when we create a new case study. And then all that information using the custom fields can be placed in the website using a template from Elementor Pro. It sounds a little bit complicated, but I will show you exactly what I mean. I add a new field, a complete website image. I will create images of the websites I make and then I show them there. And this is not a field, but this is an image. It is mandatory and I want to show the image in full size. And then another one, website, mobile, image, also an image. You can have files, so you can upload files and show them in the page. You can do whatever you want to do. And if you're ready, you need to scroll down to the location. Also really important, the post type is equal to case study. So if I click on publish, and I go to case studies and I click on add new. Now we see all that extra information, company, excerpt, a website URL. We can add an image. So that's what you can do now. And that is something I really like so far. So good. So I can add my first case study. So it's a website from Ferdy Korpershoek from the Netherlands. Really nice guy. I'm talking about myself. And then I can say something about my company. So small text that we will display in the website. And then this information, the company is Ferdy and Anna Media Enterprises Inc. LCC, whatever. Then there's an excerpt. Well, that's the text that will be on top of the website. So again, Ferdy sites. Then I use Grammarly to fix the text because I'm not from the United States or I don't. So English is not my first language, so sometimes I need some help. Then there's my website URL, https ferdykorpershoek.com. And now I want to show you something important. I love this tool. If I go to ferdykorpershoek.com, I have this tool over here. I use Google Chrome and here's go full page, a Chrome extension. And if I click on it, it's making a picture of the whole website. I can save that, edit it in Photoshop. But what can you also do? You can make it smaller, mobile friendly, and then let's do the same thing. So let me see, where are you? Go full page. I click on it and there it goes. A long, small image. And I want to do something fun in our case study area. I'm creating a portfolio so I can use this. I can download it over here, edit it in Photoshop and then import it into the website. And that's what I want to do. And before I import it, I want to go to tinypng.com. Make the file smaller. That what is what I have done. So over here, really simple. I click on add website image. Upload files, select files. And there it is. Let me see. There it is. iPhone website. I edit, but before I forgot, I need to go to uploads. I need to upload this one first. JPEG. Okay. So insert or select. There's the complete website, so not responsive. And then there's the mobile responsive website, this one. Then a third one, if I go to document and I scroll down, featured image, and there's a third one. And let me see, this one. And keep in mind, for me, I decided to go with 1280 by 914. And I do that with all my images of all my case studies, so everything will maintain the same. I click on open, set featured image. So now I have all this information. I can add a category. I can say websites. Enter. There it is. I click on publish. Publish. Okay. So now we have this information over here. Really nice. And this is what we have done with the custom fields, and this whole case study area, we created that with custom post type. So those two free tools, they're pro versions, but I use free versions, can help you to create an extra area. So now I need to go to Elementor Pro, Command E, and I need to go to the theme builder. And then I need to go to a single post, and I can add a new one. This is from my blog post, three different blog posts and a lot of colors, or templates for blog posts and different colors, because every category should have its own color. So that's what I decided over here. This one is linked to branding, this one to web design, and this one to marketing. So I want to add a new one, add new, and I want to start from scratch. We can make use of blogs, pre-made things, but I want to start from scratch. And now using Elementor Pro, we can fetch all the information from our case study post. First, I want to go over here, preview settings. I think everything is fine. Page layout, full width, and the title's okay. So I want to add an area over here. I want to make it, give it a height of 400 to start with. Then I go to the style, make a gradient. Let me see, or a gradient. With those two colors I use, I change the angle to 90. There it is. Okay. Then I want to have two columns, so I duplicate this one. If you don't see this option, go over here to the user preferences and turn on the editing handles. And now this is the great thing. I can drag a post title over here and it will automatically fetch a blog post. Well, that's not what I want. I want to get rid of it. I was just kidding, I don't need this. I scroll down and I go to the heading, and that gives us a little bit more freedom. Then I can say 30 or pursuit. But if I do that, first of all, you don't see it that well. So I go to style, make it white and make it uppercase. But then if I go to any other case study, it will say for the corpse over here. So I want to have dynamic content. So I go to content and I click over here, dynamic tags. Then I scroll down all the way and then I see ACF field. If I select it and I click on it again, sorry, when I get excited, I can tend to speed up a little bit. Then I click over here, I go to key, and then I can select one of the options, company or excerpt. I choose company. And there you'll see nothing. I click over here, I go to preview settings, and I search for 30 corpus hook. And now if I click on apply and preview, I will fetch all the information. So now it says 30 Anna Media Enterprise Inclusive LLC or LCC. That's wrong. And I cannot edit this. Why? Because it's fetching this information from our custom field with which we just created. So that's great. The second thing we can do, you can scroll down, go to the text editor, drag it here below, start typing a text, but then that text will be shown everywhere. I want to make use of a dynamic text. So first I go to the style, change the color to white. Then I want to go to advanced, background, and create a black background. And then I want to decrease the opacity, something like that. Then I go to advanced and add padding. I say, you know what? Bring it up to 25. And you know what? The margin, bring it up to 25. Why? Because I decide how my website looks. Then I go over here and I want to bring this to the center. Okay. So far, so good. Maybe click over here. And at the top, no padding. Yeah. Okay, like that. Then I want to have a call to action. And that will say view the website. So I can create a button, make it justified, and add a link. Remember, we have a website custom field. So I go to dynamic tags, I scroll down all the way, Click on it again. Now I can select it. There's the website URL. Wow. I can select this, make it open in a new window. And what happens if I create a second case study? That information will be placed over here of that other case study. So an image, all the other things we're going to do. And I will show you step by step how it needs to be done. But I'm getting excited already. I hope you do too. If you like this video, please like it and consider to subscribe for more upcoming videos about dogs and cats and WordPress. I go back over here to style. I want to make use of the background color primary. And when I hover over it, the accent, or use the primary one and make it a bit darker like that. And when we hover, we can also make it grow or shrink depending on what you prefer. I think grow is better. I like to grow in muscles. 13 and a blah, 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 blah. Okay. I think this is a little too much on top. So I go to advanced. Uncheck this. And at the top, I say, you know what? Give me some space because it's too crowded over here. You can do that pixel perfect. So you can say 82 pixels if you want to. And then here at the right, I click on the plus. I search for an image. I drag that image over here. I release it. I click on the image. No, I do not click on the image. I click over here on dynamic tags. Sorry, I'm doing the wrong thing. I select the featured image. Come on, fetch it. Yes, there it is. So, but it's here on top. So I don't want that. So what I can do, I can select that area. If I cannot reach it. So I go over here to the navigator. I go to this column. I select it over here. Then at vertical alignment, I say bottom. So it will be aligned at the bottom. And if I say over here, I want to have some more space. You see, it still aligns at the bottom. If you want to see the results, you can click over here. And this is what you will see. And you can also give this a certain amount of pixels in the width. So I go to style, pixels. And let's make it 500. So if I go like this, it will not become bigger. Okay. I like it. When I hover over it, I wanted to go up a little bit. So I thought there was something like float. Yes. And also this can be linked to that website. So at content, link, custom URL, and then I select the dynamic tag and I go to the ACF thing. I click on it and I select the URL. Okay, so far so good. If I click on publish, I can add a condition. Where do I want to display this? Well, to be honest, I don't want to display this on all blog posts. No, I can do what I can do. I can go to case studies over here and select to all case studies, all of them. Save and close. So our title, some text, click here. Oh, by the way, the text should be not this one, but over here, dynamic. We should get it from our ACF field. And I'm talking about the excerpt. Yes, we're getting there. I like it, man. I like it. I like Elementor and all that stuff that you can do with it. I can also go to the section using the navigator section. I can double click, call this hero to keep things organized. And selecting the section, I can go to style, close this. I can go to the shape divider, to the bottom, go to waves, and there they are. I can make them higher or lower. I can flip them. I can do a lot of things, but I like it. Yeah. Okay, let's make it easier. The next thing we're going to do, click on the plus over here, one area, and I go for an image. So I search for image, I drag it here, I select it. No, I do not. I go to the dynamic tags, ACF field, and I want to go for the complete website image. And There it is. Then I want to select the full size. And then over here at style, I say in percentage, show 90% of the width. Then at advanced, I want to have some margin at the top to give it some space. And if I go to the style, I want to have a shadow, box shadow. I click on it and there I see a nice shadow around it. I think that is awesome. Update. And now there's something else I like. It's a little bit tricky. It took me a long time to figure out how it works. What's the best way? I click on the plus and then I have two columns. And here in the section settings, I go to the content width and I say 1000. Okay. Then I go to the heading and I select the company name again. Okay. Then below, I want to have the post content. So we can have content over here and it will be displayed like that. Okay. Then I want to add an image and it's going to be tricky, I think. Let's see if I still remember how it is done. Okay. This image will be a cover of an iPhone. Upload files, select files. Downloads, most recent ones, iPhone cover, open, insert. So far, so good. Now I want to duplicate it. Click over here and I want to fetch the image of the mobile website. So ACF image field, select website mobile image. Okay, there it is. Image size full. It needs to be in the center. And what I want to do now, what I want when I scroll down, I want this cover to stay like this, to float with me. And then I want to show this mobile website image through this phone. So how can we do that? Well, first I click over here. And if I want to select them, you know, what I want to do, I want to give them a name. So I go to the navigator. There are two images, this one, the cover and the website. So over here, I want to say cover. And here I want to say mobile website image. So if I would go to a different page, you see the a different image and that will appear over here. So you see a mobile view. You can do that without this area, but I just want to have an extra element by making it stick. So I will show you how. It's not necessary. It's a little bit tricky. What I want to do now, go to the back end and show you how big my image is for reference and go to media. You see, I played around a lot with those images because it was hard to make it fit. So here's my image. I cannot share this with you because I bought it. It's 1000 by 1000. So there's a white area around it. And then my mobile image has a dimension of 600 by 2351. And it doesn't need to go above 2400. Otherwise, WordPress will automatically make it smaller. And then it does not fit here anymore. So over here, I want to make it sticky. So when I scroll down, it will stay with me. I go to advanced motion effects, make it sticky on top. So now it sticks, but I don't see the top. So what I can do, I can go to offset and increase it to 60. So now it looks like that. And this is what happens. Wow. Interesting. So I go over here again to advanced Z index. I did already. You need to make it 10. So it will be in front of this image below. And if I want to select this image, I go over here to navigator mobile, and then I can go to the style. I don't need to do anything over here. Advanced, all fine. And then it will look like this, but I see early corpus hook. So I want to make it a little bit smaller. How can I do that? I go to the style and then I can increase it until I think this is perfect, like that. 358. So if I update it and I take a look, it looks like that. You scroll down and then voila. But it doesn't appear immediately. So what I need to do, I need to go to the image, mobile, and then I need to make sure it will appear over here. So I go to advanced, uncheck this, and at the top I say minus, and then it can take a while before we will see it. So if I say zero behind it, yeah, that's better. So I drag it until I think it's perfectly aligned. So I don't like this. So I go down a little bit. I think this is perfect. So now when I scroll down, I see it over here. And then when we scroll further, then you see the rest of the website. Wow, I like this. It took me so long to fix this, how it is done. So that's what I like. Okay, what I also want is that when I scroll with it, that I have this area with me. We need to go to the text over here. And then I go to motion effects, also make it sticky on top. When I scroll down, I can increase the offset. Until it lines what I want. So you know what, maybe below this area. No. Go back. So what can be a problem when I scroll down all the way is that this text goes through it. So I need to select it again and then at motion effects at advanced, I say stay in column. That's what I've also done with this image over here with the cover, advanced, motion effects, and then stay in the column. Update. I scroll down. And now, yeah, this looks really nice. Okay, so I'm really happy with that. And again, you don't have to use the cover if you delete it. And you bring the normal one back over here. Update. It will look like this, which can also be an option. If I want to bring it back, Command Z. Or I go over here to the history. Like that. And that's the way the cookie crumbles. So let's go back up. Now let's talk about animations. Click over here, go to advanced, motion effects, and they can have an entrance animation like fade in left. They can make it slow, make it appear after a half second by saying 500. Then the second one, motion effects, fade in down, sorry, rather up after 0.75 seconds. And this one from the left, keep in mind that the more you do this, the slower your website becomes after 1 second. And then the latest one. Let's do something weird like that. After 1.5 seconds. And if you do this with other things, for instance, this text, you don't have to add in a delay because it will scroll or animate when you scroll there. So also over here, motion effects, bring it from the left. If you want to know more about Elementor, I have a complete tutorial about it. It's like 4 hours where I show you so much about this amazing plugin, and I have more tutorials about it, so you can watch them. So this is how it will look. Nice. If you click over here, you go to the website in a new tab. This is how it looks. Amazing. This is how it looks on a mobile. This is some text about Freddy Korpershoek. And then I want to end with a call to action. So I can click on the plus or better on the folder. And at blocks, I search for call to action. No, it's a whole category, probably call to action. If I see something I like, contact us, insert. And it's in black and white because then you can change the style really easily. So over here, play style, change it to the style of our website. Go over here to the style, change a lot of colors to white. I like to do not use labels. Username, please just say name or your name. Your name, place all the text, your email, your name. I don't want to create a password. You can add a new one and just say text area, placeholder, your message. And if you want to, you can have a phone number. And at the placeholder, I can say on which number can I reach you? Because then people know, okay, if I need to leave my phone number, it's serious business. So then people don't email you when they are not really, when they let you call you, when they leave their phone number, you know they're serious, and that will distract the people that are not serious. Like, hey, I'm just going to email 20 people and see what will happen. And when you say, hey, can I have your phone number? Where can I reach you? Then you will only have interested people fill in this form. So over here, I can say phone, your phone number, or whatever. It's necessary because we have this one already. Okay, then the colors are not that good. By the way, claim your free trial. No. I like to make it submit better. And then those colors again, at style. Fields, everything that's gray, we make it white. Buttons, sorry, here, then add hover here, and then the text white. This has nothing to do with advanced custom fields, so I will leave it as it is. And if I want to, I can make it full width over here. Get rid of the margin like that, or get in touch. So below every element, there's get in touch. Okay, this is how it looks. So if you have a different case study, everything will be placed like this. And I think that's a beautiful thing. Okay. That's our template. By the way, I should change the text, this text to checkout website. Update. I should optimize it for all devices. So how does this look? A bit weird. So over here, I can decrease this a bit. Okay. Create some space below. If I want to. This is good. Even This seems to work. And this. Okay. But then on a smartphone, things get a little bit weird. Over here, I can increase the padding again. Make the content a bit smaller. Change the line height. This is okay. Also okay. Also okay. Also okay. Well, I have to say, not bad. Okay, so let's take a look over there. Mobile image on a smartphone. Yeah, I should again make it bigger. So I have to say it's okay. Submit. Yes, update. So actually I did not have to do that much thing in order to make it optimized for all devices. So what I need to do now, I need to add a few more case studies and then I will be back with you. So as you see, I added a few more case studies, but where can I see them now? Well, actually nowhere yet. Only when I click over here or I click on view, then I can check them out. So if I would go to Command E, Theme Builder, and I go to the single post, scroll down, I think it's this one, edit. So right now you see Ferdinand Anna, I click over here, preview, and then I can select, over here I can select case study. I can say grow, there is a case study, apply a review, and what you'll see, the same layout, different information. So that's how you can do that. Update. So what I want to do, I want to create the case study page. Exit to the dashboard. I go to the home page. Case studies. Edit with Elementor. I cannot do that. So I click on edit page. When you edit it for the first time, you need to edit the page and then you can edit it with Elementor. Then I want to take a look at the results. I go to a different page. Edit with Elementor. Or maybe better, the about page. So, sorry. About. Because there I have text below. Edit. I also want to have text at the case study page. So, over here, right mouse click, copy. And paste. Okay, I change the text, of course, to case studies. Take a look at our latest projects. Awesome. Okay, well, then over here, I can have a new area. And let's see what we have. I want to fetch that information. So I can have a portfolio. I can drag it over here. What will happen? It looks like this. But what is this? These are the blog posts. And I can configure it, but I want to go to query and change it to case studies. Interesting. Okay. I like to say random. No, you're not here. I want to show them all. Let's go back to the layout. I want to have two of those areas. Show six per page. Make this large so the quality becomes better. Change the item ratio. Okay. If I hover over it, it looks like that. Query, we just discussed it. we can have a filter bar and based on categories or tags. I don't want that. Go to style. I want to have a column. Let's say 20 and also here in the row 20. Of course, here at the section, I want to have 60 pixels of space. I go back over here. Okay, I can have a border radius. Item overlay, what should happen? Well, I rather use the primary color, but then make it transparent. I should slow down a bit. I'm like, wow, we're going towards the end of the video. I want to get excited and finish it, but I will take it easy. Can I still read this text? Yes, but it can be bigger. Uppercase. DJ Faint. Maverick Khan. Courier. Okay. And then there's advanced. So this is one way. Version one. And now I can duplicate this whole area. I can go to the navigator. Drag the second section below and then right mouse click, duplicate this area or not, Command Z. So case studies, version two. What else can we do? Have an area over here, go to the elements. We can have posts. Okay, and then we go to query again, case studies. Oh, look at that. Boomlauketau. Okay, based on the date. Ordered by date. Yeah, I can also say only show the latest month, all that stuff. I think this is better. I still want to have two columns. And I can change the look of view. So this, I don't need to show myself because I know I'm the only one that creates websites. So I can say large over here, show the image. Yes. Image ratio. Again, 7372. Excerpt, do I want to show that? Yes. Excerpt length. Well, it can be everything. Or then I can say 1,000. But no, it's okay. The date, the amount of comments, the separator. We discussed it before on the blog page. Read more, no. What happens when I hover over it? Not much, I don't show the badge. I don't show the avatar. Query, talked about that. We can have pagination and we can have the style 20, bring it to the center. Yeah. Image hover. What should happen when you hover? Well, make it blurry. No. Increase the color a bit. Something should change. And also here, we can have some padding. Oh, is there a third way? I guess so. So I drag this here below. Version 3. Let me see. Posts, portfolio. Yeah, I think a gallery. Well, I think not. Well, maybe I can drag the images and then each individual image can have a caption. Well, that's it. So no. As slides, we can show them. As media, we can show them, I think. So, let's try that one. additional options. So we can choose this one and then link it to a custom URL. And that should be the URL of the case study. So let me go to the website. If I get GJ Fant, I have the link over here. And then over here, I can have the link in the same window. Do the same one with the second fitness trainer. Okay, I used the wrong image over here. Okay. So, okay. So that's the third one. I will just finish it. But what I found out is that when I go to a page, I cannot go back or see an overview. So what I want to add, I want to do so much things at the same time. So, okay, let's go back, go to grow, grab it, link. Okay, let's do, okay, that's okay. So now it can slide and we can say, make it slide until infinity. I want to show two. That's what I prefer. Again, make it, give it some space. Okay. And of course you can, by now you should know how you can adjust things. So update, and what I want to do, I want to change the template. So if I go to a certain template, I can edit a single page or post, which is this template. I scroll all the way down. And then I go to the case study page. So let me go over here. I know I'm doing a lot at the same time. I want to show this one. So I click on edit with Elementor. Then I copy this. I paste it over here. And I say show four or three columns. Four. And then show. Now let's make it three. Okay. And then I say above it, copy, paste. Okay. Then I go to the heading. I drag it over here. I bring it to the center. I say related case studies. Okay, click over here, go to query, change it to random. And I like to have two. A little bit more space, please. 60, 20. Make this uppercase and a bit bigger. You know what? 30 should be fine. Related case studies, and you see two random ones. Now we can navigate through all of them. So you see this coming back on every page. So now, if I go to, let me see, case studies, I go to fitness, I scroll down all the way. I don't see it yet. Shift Command R. There it is. And then I go to GJ Faint with the wrong image over here. And then it looks like that. And I go to a different one. And that way you can navigate everywhere. So the case study page looks like that. Three versions. And I can copy one if I want to. For instance, this one, right mouse click, copy. Then I go to the homepage. I edit it with Elementor. scroll down all the way over here, right mouse click, paste. Then I go to the section. Let me see. Is it this one? Yes. Select it. Okay, that's okay. I need to go to the heading. And that will push everything down. Watch our recent case studies. Also a little bit of spacing below. Perfect. These are shown in a random order. Update. So this is what we have. Our homepage looks nice. Some text about ourselves, our award-winning project page, people we worked for, nice animation in the background, scroll effect. These effects, watch our recent case studies. Nice. Get in touch, our footer with our stuff over here. Then we have the about page. Who we are, you can import this page with information, you can change the information. And again, this area, okay, that looks weird. No, that looks okay. Services page, you can import this. You can learn more about digital marketing. Then we have the case studies, three different versions. And what I see over here is that I forgot something. So I go to Elementor. By now, you should know what you should do in order to change it. I go over here, page layout, full width, and hide the title. Update. And what you see also is that on the homepage, there is this animation, but we don't want it every time. So I click on case studies, and there we have a different template. So immediately, it is in place. When you're at the page, you see this lining around it, border. When you scroll, it goes with you. Okay, three ways to show the case studies. Then we have the blog page, which is a template. Then we have the get in touch page. Thank you for watching this video. If you made it this far, I'm really proud of you. You did it. And I would like to say thank you. And I have another tutorial about Elementor Pro where I want to show you as much as possible. It's a 4-hour long tutorial. You can find it over here and you can watch it if you want to. Feel free to like this video, subscribe for more upcoming videos. And then I would like to say, see you in the next video. Bye-bye.